Hello everyone, welcome to Inno Tutorial. If you are new to this channel, I teach mathematics and civil engineering courses on this channel. So if you are looking for tutorials on mathematics and civil engineering courses, consider subscribing to this channel by clicking the red subscribe button under this video and hit the bell notification icon so that whenever I upload a new video, you'll be the first to get notification. So, in this lesson, we are going to discuss product rule for more than two functions. So, we are going to see how we can use product rule to find derivative of more than two functions. So, let's take a look at an example. So, if you take a look at the screen, we have an example. Now, I want to find the derivative of this function. As you can see, we are having more than two functions. As you can see, we are having three functions. So we want to use product rule to find the derivative of these functions. Now, the formula you are going to use, as you can see, the formula is going to be the derivative of the first function, then multiply by the other functions. I use some alphabets to represent these three functions. So the first function, I represent this as A. The second function, I represent this as B, and the third function, I represent this as C, okay? So now, the derivative is going to be the derivative of the first function, which is A prime, then multiply by B and multiply by C. So this is the remaining functions, then plus the first function, then multiply by the derivative of the second function, then multiply by the third function, then plus the first function multiply the second function, then multiply by the derivative of the third function. So if you have three or four or five or six functions and you want to take the derivative of these functions using product rule, what you need to do is you just need to take the derivative of one at a time and multiply that derivative by each of the others, okay? And you just take the sum of every. So you can expand this formula to fit as many as you have. So you can have like 7, 8, 9 functions. All you need to do is you just need to expand the formula. Okay, so let's deal with this. Now I'm going to use this formula. So this is f prime of s, which is the derivative, is equal to, so this is going to be a prime. So what is the derivative of 5s minus 2? That is the derivative of the first function. So derivative of 5s minus 2 is going to give us 5. So this is 5. So now we need to multiply this with the remaining functions. Okay, so this is going to be multiplied by b and multiplied by c. So this is 5 multiplied by 20 plus 3s cube, then multiply by 4 plus 4s square. So this is plus, now this is a, which is the first function. So this is 5s minus 2. So this is plus 5s minus 2. Then multiply by b prime, which is the derivative of the second function. So derivative of 20 plus 3s cube is going to give us 9s square. Okay, and derivative of 20 is 0 because derivative of any constant is always 0. So this is going to be multiplied by 9s square, and I believe you guys know how to take derivative of functions. So what you need to do is you just need to take this power, which is 3, you need to multiply it with this base, which is 3, then you have to subtract 1 from the power. So 3 multiplied 3 is going to give us 9, and 3 minus 1 is going to give us 2. So this is how I got 9s square. Then you have to multiply this by c, as you can see. So what is c? C is 4 plus 4s square. So this is multiplied by 4 plus 4s square, then plus a. What is a? A is 5s minus 2. So this is 5s minus 2, then multiply by b. B is 20 plus 3s cube, then multiply by c prime, which is the derivative of the third function. So derivative of 4 plus 4s square is going to give us 8s. So this is multiplied by 8s. So what we need to do, we just need to expand this. So now what we're going to do is we are going to multiply 20 plus 3s cube by 4 plus 4s squared. Okay, so you need to leave this 5 alone. So you have to leave this 5 alone at the moment. So this is going to be f prime of s is equal to 5, then multiply by. So this is going to be 20, is going to multiply everything inside this parenthesis. y3s cube is going to multiply everything inside this parenthesis as well. So 20 multiply 4 is going to give us 80. So this is 80. Then 20 multiply 4s squared is going to give us 80s squared. Then plus 3s cubed multiply 4 is going to give us 12s cubed. So this is plus 12s cubed. Then plus 3s cubed multiply 4s squared. This is going to give us 12s raised to the power of 5. So this is 12s raised to the power of 5. So you need to be very, very careful. As you can see, we are having a power of 3 here, and we're having a power of 2 here. So you need to add up the powers. Okay, so this is going to give us 12 versus the power of 5. So you have to close the bracket. Then plus, now we are going to multiply 5s minus 2 with 4 plus 4s squared. So we're going to take this 9s squared outside. Okay, so this is going to be plus 9s squared. So we're taking this outside. Then, so this is going to be multiplied by. So 5s multiply 4, this is going to give us 20s. So this is 20s. Then 5s multiply 4s squared, this is going to give us 20s cubed. Okay, 5s multiply 4s squared is going to give us 20s cubed. Now we also need to multiply 2 with everything inside this parenthesis. Okay, so negative 2 multiply 4 is going to give us negative 8. So this is minus 8. Then negative 2 multiply 4s squared is going to give us negative 8s squared. So this is negative 8s squared. So this is plus. Now we are going to take 8s outside. Then we are going to multiply 5s minus 2 with 20 plus 3s cubed. Okay? So this is going to be plus 8s, then multiply by. So 5s minus 20 is going to give us 100s. So this is 100s. Then 5s multiply 3s cubed is going to give us 15s raised to the power of 4. So this is positive. 15s raised to the power of 4. As you can see, the power here is 3 and the power here is 1. So you need to add up the power. Okay, now we have to multiply negative 2 with everything inside this parenthesis. So negative 2 multiply 20 is going to give us negative 40. So this is negative 40. Then negative 2 multiply 3s, multiply 3s raised to the power of 3 is going to give us negative 6s raised to the power of 3. So this is negative 6s raised to the power of 3. Now, what we're going to do is, we are going to multiply 5 with everything inside this parenthesis. Okay, so 5 multiply 80 is going to give us 400. So let me write this first. So this is f prime of s is equals to, so 5 multiply 80 is going to give us 400. Then plus 5 multiply 80 s squared is going to give us 400 s squared. So this is plus 400 s squared. Then plus 5 multiply 12s cubed is going to give us 60s cubed. So this is plus 60s cubed. Then plus 5 multiply 12s raised to the power of 5 is going to give us 60s raised to the power of 5. So this is plus 60s raised to the power of 5. Then plus, now we also need to multiply 9s raised to the power of 2 with everything inside this parenthesis. Okay, so 9s squared multiply 20s, this is going to give us 180s raised to the power of 3. So this is 180s raised to the power of 3. Then plus 9s squared multiply 20s raised to the power of 3, this is going to give us 180s raised to the power of 5. As you can see, I add up the exponent, so 3 plus 2 is 5. Then 9s squared multiply negative 8, this is going to give us negative 72s raised to the power of 2. then that x squared multiply negative 8x squared. This is going to give us negative 72x raised to the power of 4. Then we have plus. Now 8s is also going to multiply everything inside this parenthesis. Okay, so 8s multiply 100s. This is going to give us 800s squared. So this is plus 800s squared. Then plus 8s multiply 15s raised to the power of 4. This is going to give us 120s raised to the power of 5. So this is plus 120s raised to the power of 5. Then 8s multiply 40. That is 8s multiply negative 40. It's going to give us negative 320s. So this is negative 320s. Then lastly, 8s multiply negative 6 raised to the power of 3 is going to give us negative 48s raised to the power of 4. Now, as you can see, what we need to do is we just need to add up the like terms. So we are going to add up the term that have the exponent of 5, the term that have the exponent of 4, exponent of 3, exponent of 2, exponent of 1, and we're also going to add up the constant term. So let's add up the like terms. Okay, so this is going to be f prime of s, which is the derivative, is equal to, so let's first of all add up the term that has the exponent of 5, that is the highest exponent. So as you can see, we have 60s raised to the power of 5. Then what other value? We also have 180s raised to the power of 5. So 60s raised to the power of 5 plus 180s raised to the power of 5. Then what other value do we have? We also have 120s raised to the power of 5. So if you add up these values, you are going to get 360s raised to the power of 5. So this is 360s then raised to the power of 5. So the next value we are going to add is the exponent of 4. So the first value we have is negative 72. So negative 72s raised to the power of 4, then minus 48s raised to the power of 4. This is going to give us negative 120s raised to the power of 4. Then the next term we're going to add up is the term that have the exponent of 3. So the first value is 60s raised to the power of 3, then plus 180s raised to the power of 3, then what other value do we have? Okay, we don't have any other value. So 60s raised to the power of 3 plus 180s raised to the power of 3. This is going to give us positive. It's going to give us positive 240s raised to the power of 3. So the next term we're going to add is the term that have the exponent of 2. So the first term is 400s raised to the power of 2, then minus 72s raised to the power of 2, then plus 800s raised to the power of 2. So if we add up these values, we are going to get positive 1128, then multiply s raised to the power of 2. So the next value we are going to add, is the value that have just the s variable. Okay. So what term has just the s variable? Let me see. So what term, as you can see, the only term that has the s variable is negative 320s. So we're going to write this here. So this is negative 320s. Then lastly, we're going to add up the constant term. So as you can see, 400 is a constant. So what other constant term do we have? We don't have any additional constant term. So this is going to be positive 400. So we can simplify this further. So this is going to be the final answer. So this is the derivative of this function using the product rule. So this is how we can use product rule to find derivative of more than two functions. Now, if there's any part you don't understand, maybe there's a part you got confused, ask me any question in the comment section below and I will try to answer all your questions. If there's any topic you want me to cover on this channel, tell me in the comment section below and I will try to cover the topic. So see you all, have a good one, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel by clicking the red subscribe button and hit the bell notification icon below. So I'll see you all next time.